டீம் மித்ராவும் கல்விதாவும் ராவர்ட் வந்து எம்எஸ்சி மீனிங் செஷன் கூட இன்ஃபுளுன்ஸ் பண்ணாங்கல்ல அது மாதிரியா
சார்
குயிக்காக எங்கிருந்து சொல்லு So from team Dhanush, it's going to be Prasad.
All the best, Prasad.
All the best.
Appa,
what
are you proud of? Appa.
Pardon? Here, here, here. Yes.
So, good evening, everyone. So, I am before starting my presentation, I have to take a moment to appreciate our panel members because it's really a very nice task and we have to make a proverb and we have to connect with...
Thank you so much, Pop.
We have to connect with the chemistry in this session. So my first proverb is, try the best to achieve the goal. So actually, more times when sir is giving any sort of, he will give some, in each and every presentation, he will give something or he will add some points to it. So he also spoke many things about to achieve goals. So he always said try and don't stop. So whatever things come in front of your life, you want to face it and you have to try your best to achieve the goal. So that statement I... So we have to... whatever problems come in front of us, we have to try our best to find every solution. We have to go on our goals. So we have to achieve our goals. So when we are try the best and when we achieve our goals, sure we will feel some happiness that we have achieved the goal. So my next proverb is, be yourself at any point of time. So share your opinions at any point of time. Let it might be any person will tease you or don't think about it. Share your opinion and share your wishes and share everything in that moment, in that situation, what you feel, share everything in front of everyone. So be yourself, be take your own decision, so in life, in some stage, we have to take every decision. So be yourself, in each and every moment you live. So it's very important for us to live in our life to taking our own decision in every even in public, even in small thing to achieve something throughout the world. So our next proverb is, start everything at the beginning. So if, for example, if a person want to achieve a goal or if a person want to achieve something which is creativity, so he has to start thinking from his engage. So if a person want to become a doctor, he has to think that I have to become a doctor, I have to search more thing about it. And gaining knowledge is very important in every field nowadays. So we have to, gaining knowledge is very important in every field nowadays. So we have to be very patient to do our work. So definitely we have to start everything in a beginning. So from nowadays onwards, whatever goal you achieve, try to learn something from the goal. If any person is higher than you, try to respect and try to gain more knowledge from them. And my fourth proud moment, even sir said that statement. So actually I am very much impressed about that statement. So I have to link that with the semester next session. Each and every time sir will teach us live at the moment. Even in feel good factor, that was my very best presentation. Even though that time even I had school, so I have to wake up at morning. That morning I started to practice about this. I have to started to search about this feel good factors in any time. So in that time I asked about asked my mom and I shared this topic and I asked many one's opinion and I put it into it. So that statement
So I have asked them to give a bonus call for thanking the panel members and the members, and you did really well. Let's see how much mark they have. So from Team Ashwathaman, the leader Ashwathaman is now.
All the
Very quickly after that, Dhanush will go and then Lakshin and then you. So, how many people interested in Ashwathaman's team? Okay, then I think you will be the last. And then Dakshin Siddharth will be striking. We will see. Let's see. Okay, next. Come on.
Come on, Anand.
Greening.
If we are doing our own, we are doing our work, we will be feeling bored and we will be excluding them 100%, but if we are doing a teamwork, our friends will motivate us, and if any boring they will convince us, they will be talking with us, and we can finish that easily. My second thought is be normal, be active. We should always be normal, all of them, but we should not show our strength in to our weak people. Who are like age difference, we should not show our power to our.
First things first, thank you, panel members, sir, for giving me this opportunity. Now I'd like to go into your proverb. My first proverb is great pedagogues create great leaders. Great teachers, great instructors are the only persons capable of creating great leaders in the future. And we have a great teacher with us who is molding us to become future leaders. Thank you, sir, for that. So I learned the impact that a great teacher can make in the life of a young.
In the life of a young boy
or young girl. So sir is making a difference by helping each one of us and by making us to improve on our gray zones, and he's also appreciating us and making us improve on our gray zones. So thank you sir for that. My second proverb is be your own critic. Don't bother or don't care about what others say about you. You be your own critic. If you feel that you are not doing something good, criticize yourself, but not in excess. Don't let overconfidence come into you, and that will be my last power. I'll come to that later. So you have to be confident, you have to praise yourself and you have to motivate yourself when you need motivation. But don't overvalue yourself, because if you overvalue yourself, then you'll be downtrodden and you'll be pushed towards failures. So that's my second proverb, and I learned this from sir. He has already mentioned this a lot of times. My third proverb is be loyal to your vision with pride. With pride. What do I mean by that? Don't shy away from sharing your vision with others. Some people feel that if I share my dream for the future with these people, they'll start laughing at me and they'll start saying that I am not capable of doing so. So don't have that. That's why sir makes everyone everyone to do December presentations, so that everyone can know about the goals of each other and so that they can motivate each other. So I think this is another key merit of MS Evening session. So I really like that in this session. My next proverb is fun and joy can't be bidden for. You can bid for articles, you can bid for antique things, you can bid for even players, but you can't bid for fun and joy. Fun and joy are priceless. They are moments that are stored in our memory, our subconscious mind, and they keep giving us pleasure when we need them. So obviously I'll remember and cherish all the fun moments that I spent here, and I'm sure everyone will. So fun and joy, they can't be valued with just money or something else. A piece of paper cannot value fun and joy. So that's what I want to tell you. Enjoy as much as you can in school life, because when you grow up, you might not get time to be with your friends because you'll be engaged in your own work. So make use of fun and joy as much as you can. So that's my proverb. And my fifth proverb is fight with the monster, but make sure you don't become one. Sir has always told that you must rise your voice up against injustice, but make sure that you don't do injustice to anyone else. So that's what sir says. We must not be silent when we are subjected to injustice, or when we are subjected to partiality or something similar. But we have to raise our voice against them. But at the same time, we have to make sure that we don't cross any borders, we don't do any injustice to anyone else. Because like, you get what you reap what you harvest. I mean, you reap what you sow. So similarly, you must be good to others, and at the same time, when you feel that you are being neglected or you are being targeted or whatever, you have to raise your voice up against all these injustices. The sixth problem is, be a sponge to virtues, but be a wall to the evil. Here, everyone has certain unique set of qualities, each and every person, and we must not look at our age or our ego or our prestige. We must not be egoistic, and we must learn to attract the good virtues from each and every one, no matter how older they are than us or how younger they are than us. And at the same time, we must be a wall to the evil. We must not let the bad qualities of anyone to get inside us. We must only be responsible virtues of everyone and don't be egoistic, and at the same time be as much unique as possible and try to help others so that others will help you when you need them the most. My seventh proverb is fun with essence and involvement is better than academics with isolation and pressure. Fun with essence, that means fun with a great motive behind. We learn here, but we don't realize the learning process because we have fun. But at the same time, the learning is stored inside us because we know that we have learned something and the next day we become better. And we learn with fun. That is not the same case in school, because in school we have a lot of pressure and not all the people, only the toppers, the so-called toppers are like involved more, they feel much more involved with the teachers, while the backbenchers are kind of limited. So, but here, each and everyone gets involved. Sir even gets angry when even the smallest of the kids doesn't speak, because he wants everyone to feel involved, because only then you can feel the learning process. If you are involved in a group, you feel that you have learned something. But if you are neglected by the same group, then you feel that you are worthless and you won't be. You'll keep demotivating yourself if you're not involved in some activities among your peers.
Give him two bonuses.
Yes, sir.
Fine. My eighth proverb is, refreshing the brain without refreshing the limbs is like knowledge without application. Here, we do mental activities as well as physical activities. It's a combination of both. Just developing your brain and not developing your body will not lead to success. Because if you have knowledge, you must also know to apply it. Because if you just have knowledge in your head and you don't know to apply them elsewhere, then definitely you're not going to be successful. And to know this, the power of application, you must know the power of physical games, physical activities, how they can improve us. Because physical activities, they develop us as a whole. But mental activities are just restricted to our brain. But physical activities, they develop our body as a whole, including the brain. So this is what I want to say. My ninth proverb is, compete with your expertise and proficiency and not with other others. Compete with your previous peak performances. Try to emulate your previous performances and set new records. Don't target others. Because here, we don't compete with each other. We are here to develop our own character. That's what sir wants us to do. We're not here to compete with others. Because in school, always, parents ask us, what was this guy's mom? What was this girl's mom? Why did you get less marks than her? Why did you get less marks than me? It's just competing with others. So we study just for getting more marks than someone else. That's what a lot of students are doing right now. They just want to get more marks than somebody else. They don't realize that they need to develop themselves before competing with others. So that's my ninth proverb. My tenth proverb is, soft skills bolster life skills. So you need to have strong character in order to be successful in your life. Academics are important, obviously, but you know, along with that, you also need your soft skills. You need to develop your character, your self-confidence, your leadership. You need to develop all these soft skills in order to be successful. So this is the very main essence of this session. My 11th proverb is, no one can motivate yourself better than your inner angel. I'm not talking about inner human, I'm talking about inner angel. The inner angel inside you will motivate you no matter the number of adversities that you face. You don't need to search up for motivational videos in YouTube and watch them. When you yourself know, after coming to this class, that you are the sole motivator for yourself. So as many of you realize this, that you are the one who can motivate yourself and not any other person in YouTube or any other social media. So this was my 11th proverb. My 12th proverb is that the patch on your chest is more important than your name at your back. You need to play for your team, you need to do everything for your team and not for yourself. You should not be selfish. And I think I also get selfish before coming to this class, but after coming here, I think I've learned to mingle well with everyone. And I've learned to sacrifice for others. I've learned to share things with others. I love to share victories with others and not just with myself. So your patch on your chest is more important than your name that you have. My last proverb is, with great overconfidence comes great calamities. Actually, it's a parody version of, with great power comes great responsibility. I just turned it upside down and I just said, with great overconfidence comes great calamities. If we perform at our peak for like two or three occasions, we must not let overconfidence take over us, because we might fall down any time. So we must realize this and we must keep working hard in order to maintain our level. It's not about being at the top for one or two occasions. You have to be at the top forever and you have to cement your spot at the top, at the pinnacle, at the zenith. Only then people will remember you. So these were my 13 problems. The 13 problems. And thank you everyone for
fantastic presentation, Dr. Siddharth. It was